subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in the field of science and technology, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in an episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of these stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. The Republic of India celebrated its 74th Independence Day amid the worldwide pandemic. Holding a tremendous ground in the list of national days, this day reminds us of all the sacrifices that were made by our freedom fighters in order to set India free from British rule. While the spirit of nationalism in citizens was at its peak on the day, celebrations were kept a low-key affair this time to prevent the spread of virus. Have a look.
The patriotic spirit was all-time high among the Indians as the country celebrated its 74th Independence Day on 15th of August. Like every year, the annual celebrations were held at the 17th century historic Red Fort. However, this year due to the worldwide pandemic, only around 4,000 guests were allowed and made to sit 6 feet apart. Prime Minister Narendra Modi hoisted the national flag and gave a speech highlighting the glorious history of the country along with a glimpse in its future vision. He also launched some new schemes from the platform like the National Digital Health Mission for the country of 1.3 billion.
National Digital Health Mission uska bhi aarambh kiya ja raha hai. Bharat ke health sector mein ye ek nayi kranti le aayega. Ilaaj mein aane wali pareshaniyan kam karne ke liye टेक्नोलॉजी का बहुत सुविचारित रूप से उपयोग होगा. प्रत्येक भारतीय को हेल्थ आईडी दी जाएगी. ये हेल्थ आईडी प्रत्येक भारतीय के स्वास्थ्य खाते की तरह काम करेगी.
Much enthusiasm was witnessed in Jammu and Kashmir that recently completed its first year as a union territory. Cultural programs were organized in different districts of the territory where the day was celebrated with immense fervor and zeal. A number of dances, choirs and skits were organized as a part of the event, showcasing the cultural and patriotic spirit of Kashmiris and highlighting their love and dedication towards the nation.
हमारा ये प्रोग्राम होता रहता है हर साल इंडिपेंडेंस डे पे, वो 15 अगस्त हो या 26 जैन हो, हम प्रोग्राम्स करते रहते हैं. तो रही बात अभी कोविड की, तो हमें कोई वो खासी मुश्किलात का सामना नहीं करना पड़ा. हमें बस अपनी परफॉर्मेंस के साथ होता है, यही एक मौका मिलता है हमें अपना कल्चर दिखाने के लिए. और हम चाहते हैं कि हमारे कश्मीर का कल्चर आगे बढ़े ताकि पूरी दुनिया देख सके हमारे कश्मीर का कल्चर.
Meanwhile, India's Attari border with Pakistan in Punjab witnessed the beating retreat ceremony without any spectators, ending the 74th Independence Day celebrations on a silent note. Only a handful of army officials and other security personnel were present at the event. The ceremony also featured a special live musical performance by the troops of Border Security Force, giving a musical touch to the occasion.
India is well known for its religious diversity, where people of various faiths have been living together for ages. And even today, this unity in diversity is kept alive by the citizens. Recently, when the country celebrated the 74th Independence Day, the religious leaders of different groups in the capital, New Delhi, came together to hoist the national flag, spreading the message of oneness.
मजहब नहीं सिखाता आपस में बैर रखना हिंदी है हम वतन है हिंदुस्तान हमारा मीनिंग रिलीजन डज नॉट टीच अस टू बेयर इल विल अमंग आवरसेल्व्स वी आर ऑल इंडियंस एंड आवर होमलैंड इज हिंदुस्तान These words from a patriotic song turned into reality when leaders of various faiths assembled at the India Imam Organization's office in New Delhi on the occasion of 74th Independence Day. They together chanted slogans awakening national spirit and then hoisted the national flag. Spreading the message of unity and universal brotherhood.
बहुत ही खुशी का उत्सव है सब अपने अपने तरीके से देश में स्वतंत्रता दिवस मनाते हैं मगर आज पहली बार इमाम हाउस में हमारे डॉक्टर इमाम साहब उमर अहमद इलियासी साहब ने जो कार्यक्रम रखा है हिंदू मुस्लिम सिख ईसाई आपस में हैं सब भाई भाई इस प्रोग्राम के माध्यम से जैन हो बौद्ध हो भारत में रहने वाले सब धर्म के लोग एक हैं यहाँ से ये एकता का संदेश हम देना चाहते हैं
The religious leaders also praised the Prime Minister Narendra Modi for his message of unity that he gave in his Independence Day speech and even showed their support to his efforts of taking the country forward. Pointing towards India's diversity, they said that though they may have different faiths and cultures, they all are one.
हमारा भारत जिस तरह से विकास कर रहा है हमारा भारत जिस तरह से विकास की ऊंचाइयों पर जा रहा है मैं पुनः अपने प्रधानमंत्री श्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी को भी इसकी मुबारकबाद दूंगा जिनके नेतृत्व में आज भारत पूरे विश्व गुरु बनने से अब कोई रोक नहीं सकता इसी भारत की यही विशेषता है हम सब मिलकर इसमें सहयोग करेंगे अपने प्रधानमंत्री जी का उनके साथ मिलकर पूरे देश के साथ मिलकर आज हम यहाँ संकल्प लेंगे कि हम सब एक हैं और भारत और भारतीयता को मजबूत करें हमारे सबके धर्म अलग हो सकते हैं हमारी सबकी जातियां अलग हो सकती हैं इबादत करने के तरीके अलग हो सकते हैं लेकिन हमारा सबसे बड़ा जो धर्म है इंसान और इंसानियत का है दूसरा धर्म भारत में रहते हैं भारतीय का है आओ हम सब मिलकर भारत को मजबूत करें भारतीयता को मजबूत करें
Such events where people of different communities come together in the show of communal harmony play an important role in strengthening the secular fabric of the country.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Amazon.com Incorporation launched an online pharmacy in India to serve the Bengaluru city of Karnataka, the latest move by the e-commerce giant to widen its reach in a key growth market. The service Amazon Pharmacy has begun and will soon offer deliveries across the city. It offers both over-the-counter and prescription-based drugs as well as basic health devices and traditional Indian herbal medicines.
जो regular buyers हैं जिनको regular need है medicines की तो वो उनको तो stock भी करना होता है कि ठीक है जैसे अभी कितना crucial time है corona का तो लोग नहीं निकलना चाह रहे हैं घर से बाहर तो दे वो चाह रहे हैं कि ठीक है risk को ना लेते हुए हम लोग online ही order करें तो उस condition में better है.
The move comes amid increasing competition in India with rivals Walmart-owned Flipkart, billionaire Mukesh Ambani's upstart online grocery service JioMart, and a range of other smaller players.
Authorities opened a 60-meter-long double-lane motorable bridge on River Indus for public use in Ladakh territory. Lieutenant Governor of Ladakh R.K. Mathur inaugurated the bridge in territory's Choglamsar area.
ये केवल डबल लेन ब्रिज ही नहीं बल्कि एक रिकॉर्डेड टाइम पे लद्दाख ऑटोनोमस हिल डेवलपमेंट काउंसिल के द्वारा कंप्लीट हुआ एक ऐसा अच्छा प्रोजेक्ट है जो मल्टी करोड़ का जो प्रोजेक्ट और इसका बेनिफिट यहाँ के केवल छुशोत स्तकना स्तोक माशो पालम को ही नहीं बल्कि लद्दाख के सभी निवासी जो यहाँ से मुसाफिर करेंगे उन सबको इसका बेनिफिट मिलेंगे.
Ladakh is a sparsely populated region that is renowned for its surreal cold desert beauty and culture.
The famous cave shrine of Vaishno Devi situated in Katra town of Jammu and Kashmir reopened for pilgrims after being suspended for nearly 5 months due to the coronavirus pandemic. Nestled in the Trikuta Hills in the Himalayan range, the shrine attracts a large number of devotees from across the country every year. However, with coronavirus cases rapidly rising in the country, the scene this year is different as only 2,000 devotees would be allowed to visit the holy place per day.
हमें सर बहुत खुशी है इतने टाइम बाद जो माँ का दरबार खुला हमें यही था कि हम पहले जाएं और पहले जाके माँ के दर्शन करें.
The pilgrimage that was suspended on March 18 will allow 1,900 devotees from Jammu and Kashmir and rest 100 from outside the territory for the first week who will be allowed to go on the pilgrimage if they test negative for coronavirus.
With the difficult coronavirus situation, an innovation in the form of a boat ambulance in southern remote islands of country has turned out to be a life savior. The ambulance has been functional in the remote areas of Alappuzha district of Kerala, ferrying critical COVID-19 patients to hospitals.
ഇപ്പോൾ 2020 ൽ ഇതിൽ ആദ്യമായി കിടപ്പ് രോഗികളെ കൊണ്ടുവരാൻ കൊറോണ കുട്ടനാട്ടിലുള്ള ജല മേഖലയിലുള്ള ഇവരുടെ കിടപ്പ് രോഗികളെ കൊണ്ടുവരാനായിട്ട് ആദ്യമായി പോയത് ഞങ്ങളുടെ റെസ്ക്യൂ ബോട്ടിലായിരുന്നു. ഒരു 37 പരം കൊറോണ രോഗികളെയും ഈ കഴിഞ്ഞ ഏതാണ്ട് ഒരു 10 ദിവസത്തിനോടകം ഞങ്ങൾ പിക്ക് ചെയ്യുകയുണ്ടായി.
The ambulance has been active for a little over a week when the COVID-19 cases in the area are recording a rapid surge. They have picked up nearly 40 patients in time who were admitted to the hospitals on the mainland. The ambulance works 24 hours on all 7 days of week.
The holiest shrine of Sikhism, the Golden Temple, was illuminated and the skies were filled with fireworks to mark the anniversary of the installation of the religion's holy book, Guru Granth Sahib. Devotees thronged the shrine to offer prayers, light lamps and candles and witness the spectacular fireworks filling the night sky.
पहली बार यहाँ पे आई हूँ गुरुपुरब वाले दिन, और मैंने पहली बार ऐसी अष्टवाती देखी है, वो भी कोरोना के बाद।
The massive project to compile Guru Granth Sahib, which has hymns of some of the 10 Sikh Gurus and prominent saints of the medieval period, was undertaken by the fifth Guru of the Sikhs, Guru Arjan Dev. The voluminous book was finally completed in 1604 and was installed at the Golden Temple.
The COVID-19 pandemic has united the whole country into one family, whose each and every member is contributing its bit to sail through these hard times. But a few among them have just changed the definitions of compassion and empathy with their extraordinary efforts and have become an inspiration for all. One among them is the members of Youth Welfare Telangana, who have stepped in to give COVID-19 victims a dignified send-off, no matter which caste or community they belong to.
COVID-19 has posed several challenges before the country, among which performing the last rites of the patients who succumbed to the disease is the major one. In many cases, the family of a diseased is in quarantine itself, while in the few, the family may not be willing to accept the body of the patient as the contamination levels are too high and there are even chances of fatal infection if not handled with care. In such a situation, volunteers of Youth Welfare Telangana, a charitable organization based in Hyderabad, have taken up the daunting task of performing the last rites of the COVID-19 dead bodies across various districts of the state. They perform the funeral rites as per the religion of deceased. Until date, they have given a dignified send-off to 147 people, in which 14 were Hindus, one Christian, one Sikh, and the remaining were Muslims.
यहाँ हैदराबाद में हमारे युद्ध के 50 members हैं, तांडूर में 30 members हैं, और निजामबाद, आदिलाबाद और महबूबनगर में 5-5 members हैं। और दूसरे डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स में भी हम कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा और लोग को जुड़ा सकें, और कोरोना से डरने का नहीं है, इससे हम मुकाबला कर सकते हैं, एहतियात करना चाहिए, प्रिकॉशंस यूज करना चाहिए।
द टीम हैज़ अ डेडिकेटेड एम्बुलेंस एंड प्रैक्टिसेस हाई हाइजीन स्टैंडर्ड्स व्हाइल डीलिंग विद द बॉडीज। They perform the final rites of claimed bodies only, but if no objection certificate is granted, then of unclaimed bodies as well, irrespective of caste and community. The organization was also involved in several other social welfare activities, like distributing food and medicines, since the pandemic started.
कोरोना जब से शुरू हुआ, जनता कर्फ्यू के हम दूसरे दिन से ही राशन डिस्ट्रीब्यूट कर रहे थे। उसके बाद लॉकडाउन में हम जो गरीब लोग थे, जिसको मेडिसिन की परेशानी हो रही थी, हमको फ्री में मेडिसिन भी डिस्ट्रीब्यूट करे सहायता ट्रस्ट के साथ में मिलके और टीम एनजीओ के साथ मिलके।
Rising above religious biases and working with only motive to serve the humanity, this is what these volunteers from Telangana have been doing. Their work is inspiration for everyone to come forward and help the country at this time of need.
Michael Phelps once said, "You cannot put a limit to anything. The more you dream, the further you get." It takes a lot of perseverance and hard work to push one's own limits and achieve something that has never been done before. So, Today we'll meet two such individuals from Chennai who decided to push their own boundaries and attempted world records.
India is home to a number of talented individuals who hold different types of world records registered to their name. In the year 2020, as many as 80 world records made by Indians have found a place in the latest list of Guinness World Records 2020. One such unique record holder is a 5-year-old from Chennai who made a world record by shooting the maximum number of arrows in a suspended position. Sanjana attempted this world record on the occasion of Independence Day this year in the presence of eminent personalities like the Secretary General of Archery Association of India and the President of Delhi Archery Association, along with a panel of judges who were monitoring the event via video conferencing. She became the first child to shoot 111 arrows in a span of 13 minutes in an upside-down position. Sanjana's parents and trainer are proud of her endeavors as they hope that in future she will bring a medal in Olympics for the nation.
In the entire history of archery, never has any human ever tried shooting upside down. When the whole world is upside down during Corona days, we thought it is a good thing that we send a message to the entire world, a positive message to the entire world through this little child that whatever happens to humanity, we'll continue to succeed.
Another such artist is Shiva Raman, who attempted to break the Guinness Book of World Record by making possibly the largest portrait of the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi. Based in Chennai city, Shiva's artwork is a combination of 74 face portraits of the great freedom fighter. He attempted making 185.8 square meter portrait of Gandhi with coffee powder on the occasion of 74th Independence Day. Shiva is an art teacher at a private school. He completed his artwork in a total of 24 hours.
We decided that we would promote our budding talent, Mr. Sivaraman, to paint a portrait of 73 Gandhi faces, which he's already completed. This is to promote nationalism and patriotism. He's making a portrait of 185.8 square meters, which is around 2,020 square meters.
It is due to such talented individuals that India continues to be the land of wonders, making its own unique identity in the eyes of the world.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host, Shreya Savijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.